What are the best eye drops if you have keratoconus? Let's talk about that in this video. First of all, I mean, technically the best eye drop is one called riboflavin eye drops, and it's shining ultraviolet UV radiation on your eyes to cross-link it. But that's something that you'd have to go in for a surgery and see a doctor for. That's not what you're looking for in this video, but technically the best eye drops are the riboflavin kind to do cross-linking. Now, what are some other eye drops you can use though when you're at home and that you can easily purchase online or at your local drugstore? A few of them. First of all, I'm trying to convince or persuade all of my patients with keratoconus to stop rubbing their eyes. They complain that it gets super itchy and they rub their eyes. And we do know that people who rub their eyes, unfortunately, might be damaging their eyes and making keratoconus worse. So we're trying to get people to stop rubbing their eyes. So how do we do that? A lot of times people rub their eyes because they're just really itchy. They've got allergy issues. And one of my favorite drops to prevent and treat allergies of the eye is called Pataday. P-A-T-A-Day. Pataday. I like that drop because you just need to use it once a day. It's extremely effective. And as far as all the over-the-counter ones to treat eye allergies, that is probably my favorite one and one I recommend routinely at my office. And if your eyes stop itching, hopefully you'll not rub your eyes as much, which is extremely important if you have keratoconus. Another eye drop that I like is sometimes when patients are wearing their contact lenses, so a lot of my patients who have keratoconus wear scleral contact lenses, I like to recommend they use preservative-free artificial tears to moisturize their eyes over time. My favorite one right now is Refresh Plus. No financial disclosures, but I like Refresh Plus a lot because there's no preservatives in it. They can put it right directly over the contact lenses. If you're having issues with the scleral lenses fogging, one of my favorite eye drops to prevent the scleral lenses from fogging is called Refresh Cellufisk. And so what those patients do is they might fill the bowl of the lens with a little bit of saline, and then they add just a couple of drops of Refresh Cellufisk into the bowl too. It makes the soup that's inside the scleral lens bowl a little bit thicker. And so when they put it on, the contact lens, the vision is able to last all day long with less fogging. So I like Refresh Cellufisk to fill the bowl of the contact lens on before you put the lens on to prevent fogging in a lot of our patients. I like it because there's no preservatives in Refresh Cellufisk, Refresh Plus. Those are the little clear, little plasticky single-use tubes that you use to place the drops into your eyes. I like those versus the big bottles that have a solution in them. The last thing is watch out for using to fill out your scleral lenses. If you wear scleral lenses, for instance, I like preservative-free saline solutions. Like a lot of my patients use Adipack, which you can buy on Amazon or I'm sure a lot of places online. For some patients, this has been game-changing. It's hit or miss with some, but game-changing for others. There's a newer solution that they're using to fill the scleral lens bowl. It's called Neutrophil. Neutrophil. You can buy that online too. It has more electrolytes and more pH balanced materials in it to help those patients wear lenses more comfortably all day long. So if you have some discomfort with wearing your contact lenses, you should look into trying Neutrophil. That might be a lot better for you than just a sterile saline Adipax, for instance. So these are some of the solutions and eye drops you can use to help treat your keratoconus. Hopefully it was helpful for you. You can certainly learn more about keratoconus and how to treat it if you want to visit me at my office or come visit our office in general, which is, and you can learn more at insightvisionoc.com and click on keratoconus.